What is happening, guys? Evan TechSource, and today I have a very exciting video for you all because I'll be building a custom gaming PC inside the brand new Hite Y40 case. My initial impressions with this case when it first arrived was if Li and Li went into a bar and bought a drink for NZXT, then they went back home and smashed. 9 months later, this is what their mistake child would look like. It's kind of like a mix between an O11 Dynamic and an H5 Elite. It is the little stepsister of the popular Hite Y60. However, this one has some nice improvements over the last version, like an extra slot in the back, providing support for even the most chonky cards out there, like NVIDIA's 40 series GPUs. Overall, this is a smaller case than the Y60. It's about 10 liters smaller. It's actually taller, but it's thinner because they moved the power supply compartment from the back to the bottom, increasing the height of the case. But yeah, super excited to finally build this case. Let's begin. So you just build a brand new shiny PC and you're greeted with this nasty notification on the bottom right corner of your screen. Well, instead of going out there and paying full price for a Windows key, you guys can actually get one for less than $15. That's right, you guys can get a Windows 10 Pro CD key for less than $15 by visiting yourcdkey.com or by clicking my link below and using my code TS20 for that extra 20% off. They also sell Windows 11 and Microsoft Office keys, and the same discount code applies. Now, once you get your CD key, all you have to do is go into the activation settings on Windows and put in the new key and watch the watermark disappear.
So for the CPU, we're going with the Ryzen 9 7950X yet again. This is AMD's fastest consumer grade Zen 4 processor. In fact, I just got done building another PC last week using the same CPU. We are also sticking with the same exact motherboard to stay consistent with the color scheme. This is also the only motherboard, to my knowledge, for the AM5 platform that has a white theme. So yeah, the choice is pretty simple. Have you guys guessed what memory we're using for the build? Surprise, surprise. We're going with the Corsair Vengeance RGB DDR5. So pretty much the motherboard, CPU, and the memory are the exact same as Frost V3. But it's still gonna look completely different than the last build, I promise you guys that. So we're going with two 32 gigabyte kits for a total of 64 gigabytes running at 6200 megahertz. I keep talking about color schemes, but I don't think I've mentioned what color scheme I'm going with. If it isn't already obvious, so the Y40 actually comes in the same colors as the Y60. You get the black, white, or the red option. And I know a lot of us watching this video or just YouTube videos in general are tired of seeing white case builds. So I thought I would change it up and go with a red one this time. I feel like black and red is also very common, so I decided to change that up as well and go with a red and white theme. To kind of pay homage to the original Big Red version 3 build with the white and red colors, I do miss those colors a lot. So I thought, why not do it for this build? So naturally, I'm calling this Mini Red version 2. Because, well, version 1 already exists. So for the cooler, I'm going with the new Deepcool LT720 360 AIO, simply because I love the look of it. But I'm not too crazy about the color choice, and it's gonna interfere with the color scheme of my build, and when I don't like the appearance of something, I change it using some paint. I did a video showing this entire process. If you guys are interested, you can check it out. I'm also not too crazy about the fans. They're gonna stick out against the white radiator, so I'm gonna be replacing these and go with the brand new SL120 V2s from Li & Li. I've actually been dying to use these fans in a build, so this is the perfect opportunity. Just gotta snap these bad boys together. One of the upgrades from the Y60 is that the riser cable is now a PCI Gen 4 riser cable. So if you're installing an NVIDIA 30 series card or higher, you don't have to go in the BIOS and change the PCI settings. You're pretty much good to go with this. Okay, so the Y40 supports up to a 360 millimeter radiator on the top. So that is the only place where we can mount the AIO. You can also mount up to a 280 mil rad over here on the side. Either 280 or 240 will fit over there, but we're gonna be using that area to add two intake fans instead. There is one more intake fan on the bottom underneath the power supply shroud, a very interesting place to put a fan. We'll see if it does anything for thermals. And then we have one more exhaust fan back here. So total 3 intake and 4 exhaust. So a little bit of a negative pressure going on in the case, but I don't think it's gonna be too big of a deal. That's what I love about this case so much. All the panels are pop-off. It's so easy working with this case. You don't have to deal with any thumb screws, which is awesome. Even the back and the front panels are pop-off. Look at that. Super convenient, I love it. Are we gonna run into a clearance issue like Frost V3, or is this gonna work out? Oh wow, that is a super tight fit. Look at that. Oh, look at that. I might have to remove the exhaust fan to get back there. Yeah, that does not work. That does not work indeed. I guess I did not read the fine print, but if you want to install a 360 mil radiator, you're not gonna be able to use the exhaust fan that's included in the case. You know what, this actually even works out, because if we remove this, then we'll have perfect neutral pressure in the case with 3 intake and 3 exhaust. Okay, let's try this again. Oh yeah, much better. You can't even see the radiator, dude. What? You can't even see the radiator. Why did I paint it? Oh my God, all that work for nothing. It's so like recessed in there that the only thing you can see are the fans. Oh man. You know what though? I had to paint the pump anyway, so I guess my efforts didn't go to waste after all. I guess one thing you guys can learn from my mistake is if you're building in this case and you're installing your AIO or your radiator on the top, make sure to plug in the cables on the top of your motherboard first before you install your radiator, because as you can see here, there is no way for me to access the fan header or even the EPS cables on the back here. So that's one thing you guys can do differently. So I'm gonna have to take the radiator down, plug in the cables first before I put the AIO back on. I gotta hand it to the case manufacturer for including this. So they included a massive cutout on the top panel of the case, giving you, I wouldn't say easy access, but giving you access to the top area of the motherboard. So let's say if you wanna swap fans or change out the cables, you can actually do that without having to remove your entire radiator or AIO. So, I mean, it's gonna be difficult to obviously, you know, replace the EPS cables, but it's a lot easier to access your fan headers and your 3-pin or your 4-pin RGB headers as well. So I think that's pretty cool. The Amp 1000 watt power supply. This is the white edition, so it matches the color scheme, obviously. But more importantly, it's got plenty of juice to power the entire system. In fact, this is the same exact power supply I'm gonna be using in Big Red version 5 once I'm done with this. Now, even though the stock cables are already in white, it's the crappy kind of cables. They don't look nice, they're made out of rubber, and they don't even have cable combs. And personally, I wanna go with a different pattern, so I ordered some high quality cable extensions from Amazon. And what I like about these the most is that the connector is in white. You don't normally get that from extension cables. This is a premium add-on and it comes with white cable combs as well. It's literally perfect for this build. All right, last but not least, it's time to pop in the graphics card. Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to the world's first one-of-one exclusive ASUS RTX 4090 Tough graphics card in white. I'm just kidding, it's a regular 4090 Tough that I took apart and I painted in white so it matches the color scheme. In fact, I included the mod in my last vlog, so if you guys wanna know how I custom painted the card, you can watch the video by clicking on the top right bubble. But it's crazy to me how, you know, there's such a high demand in white cards, yet manufacturers aren't taking advantage of this. We only have an RTX 4090 Strix in white and the Hall of Fame, to my knowledge. Those are only two 40 series cards in white that we have access to. So yeah, I decided to paint my own so that, you know, it matches the color scheme. So let's go to pop this bad boy in. Mm-hmm.
know how I feel about the tubes resting on the Gravis card, but don't think it's a huge deal, to be honest. I also picked up this 12VH power cable extension from Amazon. Looks like they're finally starting to sell these on there for the 40 series card. So I'm gonna be going with this instead of the nasty stock 16 pin cable, just because it looks a lot nicer. I couldn't find one in white and red, and my custom order from Cable Mod isn't here. It's delayed for another 2 weeks. So I went on Amazon and got this instead, which honestly, I think it's gonna work nice with the build. You know what? I don't like the look of that. Let me see if I can move the tubes out of the way. Yeah, I think this actually looks better. And it won't come in contact with the cable. So let's try this. That looks better. Yeah, okay. Oh man, you know what guys, I tried. That's all I can say. I spent 3 hours trying to change the damn lights on the motherboard and the pump cover, but it doesn't work. The motherboard is not even being recognized by the ROG Armory. The graphics card is the only thing that I recognized. So at least I was able to change the color of that, but I'm stuck with the RGB puke for the IO cover and the AIO pump. I've reinstalled the software multiple times. I've even used older versions. Nothing seems to work. So I've decided to just move on because this is not worth any more headaches. But other than that, I think the build came out looking really good. I love the design of the case. It was very easy to build in, tons of extra space to support big components. The only clearance issue I ran into was with the rear fan. Now, even though the radiator is tucked away deep up top, there is still not enough space to mount a 120mm exhaust fan in the back because the fans on the radiator simply don't allow that. I mean, you can technically still install one if you really want to, but I don't recommend it because the bottom half of the fan is not going to be attached to anything and it's going to be sitting really close to the vertically mounted GPU. It's going to look really awkward, so it's better not to install anything in the back. I don't think you'll need one anyways, since you can install two fans on the side here for intake, plus you have one more intake fan on the bottom. Speaking of which, there is no sort of shroud or protection that will prevent the cables from touching the fan blade, so you have to be mindful of that when you're dumping your excess cables in here. It's great that they gave us all this extra space to use, but they kind of fell short on the execution. A simple fix to this would have been to include an optional fan grill that we can put on top of the fan. That would have prevented the cables from hitting the fan blades. If you're building in the Y40, your only option of GPU mounting is vertical. That's how the case is designed. This means you can't install any PCI Express cards in the back unless they are half height. This means the bracket of your PCI card has to be half the length of a full PCI bracket in order for it to work. Personally, I don't see that being a huge deal because I feel like a lot of people don't use PCI cards in mid-range to high-end builds. Like, you don't need a Wi-Fi adapter, you don't need a sound card. All those are included in a quality motherboard. And if you're buying this case, which is $150 by the way, you're definitely not doing a budget build. You're doing either a mid-range to a high-end build, and you don't really need to use a PCI card. Besides, most PCI cards out there come with an optional shorter bracket, so you can convert it if you want. But if that's gonna be an issue for you, then this case is not for you. One area they can improve with the case design is the filter integration, specifically the bottom fan filters. This one over here closer to the back is really difficult to pull out. Typically, you can just slide out air filters on other cases, but this one doesn't come out because it comes in contact with this rivet pin that's inside the case. So what you have to do is you actually have to pull the filter away from the case as you're sliding it out. And even though I know how to do it, it's still difficult to do it. Bruh. I can't do it. There we go. See how difficult it was to pull out the filter? Luckily, the other one doesn't have this issue because you're pulling the filter out from the back. But yeah, thought I'd point it out anyways. Temps-wise, the GPU did very well. Even after painting the entire card, I read a lot of comments in the last video saying that, Ed, you shouldn't paint GPUs, you shouldn't paint the fans, it's gonna throw off the balance, it's gonna affect temps. Guys, relax.
everything's fine. The GPU barely cracked 55 degrees Celsius in Warzone 2. I mean, it's one of the coolest 4090s I've used. Now that I'm thinking about it, I should have used this card for Frost V3. I should have waited one more week and put that in there. Definitely a missed opportunity, but yeah, that's all I got for the Hite Y40. An awesome case, it's got my two thumbs up. I definitely wanna do another build in it, preferably in the white option, once I get my hands on that. If you guys wanna check it out, I'll drop a link to it down below along with all the parts I used in the build. Subscribe for more awesome PC builds coming your way. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys very soon in the next one.